The Vermont Assistive Technology Program presents macOS Switch Control.
Today we're going to be reviewing Switch Control, which allows an individual to access a trackpad, mouse, or keyboard with an external button.
And it is a switch that enables a user to activate a switch-enabled device.
The devices that you see right now are called switches. These exist for individuals who cannot physically access a mouse or an external mouse. These devices connect to something called a switch interface, which allow you to perform different functions on a computer without using a mouse or trackpad. In front of us are two of the most common types of switches: the egg switch, which is a mechanical switch that requires physical force, and a proximity switch, which requires no physical force and just proximity to it to perform a function. In order to connect these switches to a computer, you need to use something called a switch interface. Here is a switch interface called the Pro 5.0. It has been discontinued, but has been replaced with the AbleNet Hitch. That is a switch interface that now will allow you to perform different functions and program different functions when you want to use different types of keys on the keyboard or when you want to perform different functions on a keyboard. In front of us is a switch interface, which allows us to connect different switches to the computer so we can perform different functions. This switch control connects to the computer via USB, and then switches connect via 3.5 millimeter jack, which is essentially like a headphone jack. Each column shows different functions that you can assign to different switches. You can choose one function per switch. So if we had a switch in this port, you can choose one of these functions within the column. The way you choose which function to assign is by hitting this mode button up top. The mode button will allow you to scroll down between four colors: green, blue, red, and yellow. So if you plug in a switch into this port, you will be accessing this column. When you change the mode to green, you will get a down arrow when you press the switch. When it is blue, you will be able to hit enter with the switch. When it is red, you can program whatever function you would like. When it is yellow, you can right-click, and so on and so forth as you go through the ports on the switch control.
So first you navigate to the System Preferences app. Once that opens, you go to Accessibility. And under Accessibility, we're going to scroll down until we reach the subsection called Motor, and we're going to select Switch Control. Under Switch Control, you have four tabs: General, Typing, Switches, and Navigation. Under General is where we can enable switch control. We're not going to turn this on yet because we haven't set up which switch is going to do which. In order to set up the switches, we go to the third tab, Switches. And this is where we're going to input our switches and what button they represent. So on the Don Johnson switch interface, I'm in the second mode, the blue mode, which means that switch port number one represents space, and switch port number two represents enter. Now, if these didn't exist, I'd be able to add a new switch by pressing the plus button down at the bottom of those menus. And then it asks you to select your switch. Press it out in the real world here. So let's say I'm installing switch port number three. I'd make sure the switch that I activate is plugged into the third switch port. I activate it, which I just tap my switch now. I'm going to name this blue because that's the mode I'm in, and I'm going to name it tab because that's what the third switch port on the Don Johnston indicates. Now, once you select your switch, you can identify the action that you'd like it to perform. The most common ones are select item and move to next item, and that is how you would navigate around the screen. So you can move to the next item and then select an item. The other options are restart from the top. Let's say you went past what you wanted and you just like to restart. Or you can stop scanning or you can click on custom. And then there's custom scripts that you could actually write, but we won't get into that today. So let's just say that the third switch port is going to be restart from top. You can also decide what press and hold does. I usually just select does nothing. Then we press done. So now we've got a third switch in here. So on mine, the first switch port called space is going to select the item that I'm on. The second switch port, the enter button, will move to the next item. And the third switch port will go to the restart from the top of my switch scanning. Also under switches, you'll find an option for auto scanning. If you are unable to have two switches for whatever reason, maybe you only have one switch site that is accessible to you, auto scanning will complete this move to next item function automatically. And so what that does is it moves the cursor at the indicated speed that you tell it under timing. And then all you have to do is select the item by pressing, in this case, the switch plugged into switch port number one. I'm going to turn off auto scanning for this, so I'll be required to use two switches. So now if we just go back to general, we're able to rock and roll with those two switches plugged in. And we just check it off. And you should see that this menu pops up called Home Switch. To navigate the Home Switch menu, I could use my switches now. So switch port number two will move to the next item. Currently, keyboard is highlighted. If I tap my switch, then next is pointer, app, dock, menu bar, system. So every time I tap, that little white square moves over one item in this bar. Now let's say I want my keyboard to show up. I would navigate using my move to next item switch until I got to keyboard. And then I would use my switch plugged into port one to select. So I'm just going to click that switch. And now the keyboard shows up. No suggestions is currently highlighted. If I press my second switch, you can see that it's moving down to different rows in the keyboard. It has the whole row highlighted. So if I was to type my name, Tracy, in the box, I would keep tapping until I landed on the keyboard row with T in it. I would hit my select switch. Now it has the tab QWE highlighted, which is not, there's no T in there, so I would press the next key over. RTYU is highlighted, which is what I would want, because T. I'd hit my select button. Now it's going to navigate between each key in the keyboard. R is selected. I'd like T. I click T. It selects T. That's the keyboard. So to exit the keyboard, you have to tab all the way to the bottom, which then brings you to the very top. And we're going to the very small home icon in the upper right. Once we're there, I hit my select item switch, and we go back to our general navigation. The next one is pointer. If I select that, this allows me to move the mouse pointer wherever I want. So let's say I want to close the accessibility settings. I'm going to use the move and click function, So I'm going to select that because it's highlighted currently. Now I get these crosshairs that show up, and I'm just going to hit click every time the wide bar is over the selection point. So what that did was create a crosshair, and I clicked where the crosshairs intersect. So that's called move and click, and that automatically does a left click. In this menu, you'll also see just move, which won't click when the mouse pointer gets there. Left click, double click, right click, click and hold, scroll down, scroll up. So this gives you full access to all of the mouse functions. Again, to navigate out of this menu, you navigate all the way through until you get back up to the home icon, and then you can select the home button and it brings you back home. And just like with the virtual keyboard in our last video, you can customize these panels very easily using the editor panel. So if again you go to System Preferences, back into Accessibility, back under the motor subsection of Switch Control, I'm just going to turn off Switch Control real quick. And then down in the bottom of the General tab, you see Panel Editor. And you can watch the video on the virtual keyboard to learn how to use Switch Editor. It's very much the same, and you can add custom buttons to perform custom actions or to type in passwords, for example, or email addresses, things like that. So you can really make this your own. To access those custom panels, you would use the custom button. So once I turn Switch Control back on, the third one from the right is custom, and this will bring up the list, the custom list of Switch panels that you have. So that is Switch Control in a short nutshell.